Hi there. I hope the course is going well for you so far and that you're learning so much. Today is another fun session where we will get into some mathematical computations. Our goals for today are, we will define several types of GDP measures. We'll also learn how to calculate GDP per capita. We will define what nominal and real GDP are and how they are calculated. Let's start with some definitions. There are several ways to talk about GDP, and each one of them is useful in its own way. First is nominal GDP. Nominal GDP is the total GDP. Nominal means that it does not control for cost of living or differences in population. So it isn't a good measure to use when we want to compare across time or compare different country sizes. We will use nominal GDP to calculate more accurate measures of GDP. Using it alone is actually misleading and can lead us to make inaccurate assessments. Second is real GDP. Real GDP controls for differences in the price level. So it allows us to compare across different places with different cost of living and different prices. It also allows us to compare across time, since this measure eliminates price differences. However, the issue with real GDP is that it does not control for population sizes. Real GDP allows us to measure the overall production while controlling for prices, but does not allow us to understand production per person. To do that, we will use real GDP per capita. This is the best measure to use when comparing living standards across countries and through time. It controls for both changes in prices and changes in population size, allowing us to compare apples to apples. We will mostly use real GDP to measure total production and real GDP per capita to measure living standards. Let us look at this example of how these measures are actually used. This is information based on 2013 data. The three top-ranked economies by real GDP are 1, the United States, 2, China, 3, Japan. The real GDP of the United States is $16.7 trillion. The real GDP for China is $9.2 trillion. And the real GDP of Japan is $4.2 trillion. You will notice the gap between the US and China is almost 2 times, and between US and Japan is almost 4 times. As you know, these are total numbers. All three countries vary in population size. So to compare living standards, we will calculate GDP per capita. Remember that real GDP per capita is equal to total real GDP divided by population size. We find that the US GDP per capita is $53,042, whereas for China, it is $6,807. The gap between the countries is larger when we take population into consideration. The US average living standards are actually 7.7 times larger than China's. On the other hand, Japan's real GDP per capita is $38,634, a much smaller gap than indicated by total real GDP. So Japan, in terms of living standards, has a better living standard than in China, although the total production and output is lower. Both total real GDP and real GDP per capita are important and tell us different things. However, it is important to be explicit about which measure we are using for the sake of comparison and accuracy. Now let's talk about real and nominal GDP and how they are calculated. So far, these numbers have been given to you. To show you how it's calculated, let's go back to our definition of GDP. Remember, we want to measure the value of final goods and services in the economy. Goods are tangibles like food, clothing, cars, houses. Services are intangibles like healthcare, entertainment, advice, travel, banking. We will want to account for all those things happening in the economy. In the US, the economy has become more service-oriented over the past 50 years. Today, services account for roughly 70% of GDP.
Thank
Think about an economy that produces four goods and services. Good A, B, C, and D. Good D is an intermediate good and is used entirely in the production of other goods. We also have 2 years of data, 2012 and 2013. This is obviously a very simplified example because the reality is that there are hundreds of thousands of products and services in the US economy. For simplicity, we will make these adjustments. To calculate nominal GDP for each year, we multiply the quantity by price for each product. That will give us the amount that good contributes to the nominal GDP. In 2012, there were 500 units of good A produced at a price of $2. Therefore, good A contributes $1,000 to nominal GDP. Good B has a price of $4 and 1,000 units produced, contributing $4,000. Good C has a price of $2 and 200 units are produced, contributing $400 to nominal GDP. And good D? Good D is not included because it's an intermediate good. So our total nominal GDP for 2012 is $5,400. Next, calculate nominal GDP for 2013. Here's the information. Pause the video and try it out. Did you get it? This is how my work looks. Did you get the same thing? Total nominal GDP for 2013 is $6,300. Great work. One thing you noticed is both prices and quantities changed between 2012 and 2013. So it's hard for us to evaluate if our production actually grew or if our growth was entirely because prices changed. We will have to calculate real GDP. To calculate real GDP, we need to hold prices constant. The year we hold prices constant at is called our base year. Sometimes graphs will tell you what base year they are using. In our example, we will use 2012 as the base year. So we will calculate the value of production holding prices constant at 2012 levels. So for 2012, the real GDP calculation is prices of 2012 times quantity of 2012, which is exactly the same for nominal GDP. The real GDP and nominal GDP are always equal in the base year. Let us try to calculate real GDP for 2013. We will multiply price of the product from 2012 by the quantity of 2013. Try it out. What is real GDP in 2013? My answer is $5,400. What does this mean? The entire growth in nominal GDP was driven by changes in prices. In real terms, this country experienced no growth. Interesting, huh? I hope this shows you why measuring real GDP is important. We covered a lot of great information this class. We introduced total nominal GDP, total real GDP, and real GDP per capita. We did a mathematical example to show how nominal and real GDP are calculated. Make sure to take the time to do some of the practice questions. If you need help with any of the math, please reach out. See you next class.